Hi everyone, Mrs. O'Connor Vince here. I realize that some of you are a little confused with some of the directions that I gave for this week's assignment. So I just wanted to make this short video to kind of walk you through how to do this assignment. And hopefully this will begin to get a little bit more familiar with our platform, MusicFirst. Also remember that you can email me anytime. Previously, I've used Soundtrap and Project Prompts as a way of assessing you. If you have not completed some of the project prompts from previous weeks, I invite you to do them. You can submit them to me at any time. Right now, I'm giving you feedback in the Soundtrap Messenger. If you prefer email, I have no problem with that either. It's really important that you do communicate if you need help. Because I am actively on my computer, I will most likely see your request for help sooner versus later. So it's, again, very important for you to be comfortable in reaching out and asking for help. Please, 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 if you don't understand something, just ask. And I am here to help you. I'm here to support you. And it's really important that if something isn't clear to you, maybe it's not clear to everyone, and maybe I need to do a better job in explaining what the project prompt or what the directions are. So again, don't be afraid to speak out or ask for help, even if you feel like it's really silly, even if you feel like it's a stupid question. It's not. This whole thing is very unfamiliar. And again, I think it's important that we use some of our resources to the best of our abilities. Okay, so here we go. Okay, so here on MusicFirst, there are a couple of different ways to access this work. If you go straight to the MusicFirst platform, again, it's barnstable.musicfirstclassroom.com. And again, I will put the link for MusicFirst up on Google Classroom. This is what my homepage looks like. Obviously, you guys would only be enrolled in one class. So let's say we click on a class, and this is what you guys see. So if you see something here that you have not done yet, this is basically your assignment. So for example, if I click on the strings assessment, if you see something that is not completed, this is where you want to click it. So most of you have probably seen this in Google Classroom rather than MusicFirst. So let's open that just so you can kind of see what that looks like. So for example, if I look at ViewBlock here, so this is probably what you guys see, right? Violin, viola, cello, bass, and harp. So if I click on this, this is what you guys see, and it has a link to MusicFirst. Now, what I've done is I've integrated the two. So whatever you do in MusicFirst will now be communicated through Google Classroom as well. So it's a two-way street now. So this is what you guys see. I've had some students inquire saying, well, the button doesn't work. It's a picture, okay? This is just a picture for you to look at. This is what you want to click on. This is the actual assignment, open and focus on sound. Now remember, this is how you guys access Soundtrap here, right? You click on software. This is just a different piece of software, okay? So it's not entirely new. It looks a little bit different, but you want to click it on focus on sound. This is going to bring you to this site here. That initial thing pops up because I'm the teacher, so I can edit what you guys see. And this is the harp lesson. Okay, so what I expect you to do is to go through violin, viola, cello, bass, and harp. These aren't long. They're really just like playing examples and a little bit of info on each one. You can kind of click around here If you read music, you can look at this. You don't have to. Some more video examples here. And this is really a walkthrough of each instrument. I also have these, the Philharmonic videos on my website, which I will show you in a second. But anyway, so that this button is super important. So it's not this picture, it's this button. This is the Focus on Sound icon. This is what you want to open. Okay. Now, with that being said, again, if we go back here to Google Classroom, so you have to go through each one of those lessons, and then you have an assessment to turn in. So again, if I click on this here, click out of this one so you can see this. This is your assessment. So again, open in Focus on Sound. Okay, obviously if you just go to Music First, that's not doing anything. So you always need to click what the program software that we are using in. So again, that just comes up for me. Won't come up for you. Okay, and this is what your assignment is this week. So go through the lessons, okay, and then you want to take this assessment. And it guides you through listening and questions based off of those assessment, those lessons that you read through. Okay, now when you finish this, okay, it will not only complete, it'll turn it in for you on Google Classroom so I can see that you did it, but it'll also do it here through Music First so I can see that you did it in two places, okay? So again, it's really important that you go through the lessons and then you take this quick assessment by the end of the week, okay? Please, 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 if you are confused, I know we haven't used Focus on Sound too much in class yet, so this is something new for you. It's a little new for me too. So this is something, you know, that we can kind of help each other out. So the more that you let me know what other questions you might have, the more specific instructions that I can kind of give you. Okay. Okay. And how I mentioned the videos are actually on my website as well. So again, if you want to reference this later, or maybe this will just help you with a deeper understanding here, this is something that you can access as well. So musicoconnor.com, I'll put the link on Google Classroom. If you hover over Music Tech, I'm not clicking anything yet, right? Hover all the way down here to Instruments. This is going to give you instruments of the orchestra and instruments of the concert band and individual families. So for this week, we're looking at strings. So it's appropriate that we click on strings here. And this is just kind of like my summary of the string family. So again, maybe this will just kind of help you or give you a deeper understanding or a different understanding of each one of these instruments, because these are a little different examples here. So the violin, and as you can see, I have those same videos from the Philharmonic posted in here as well. Viola, cello, bass or double bass, and harp. So those are the five instruments that you will be tested on this week. Piano is also in the strings family, but on Focus on Sound, they put it more in the percussion family. It's arguably in both percussion and string family because the little hammers inside of the piano hit the strings. So that's why you'll see piano in here and not in your assessment this week. But anyway, I try and give you more modern kind of examples just so you can kind of see how it's used more in a pop realm or more in a rock or not necessarily a classical realm. And then the example video kind of shows you how it's more appropriate in the classical setting. So I hope this has helped. again, if you guys have any questions, please do not hesitate to ask me. It's really important that we keep this open communication, just for all of our benefits, for your learning, for my teaching, etc. I hope to see you tomorrow, Wednesday. We're going to be doing, I'll be doing some Google Meet opportunities with all of our classes. So I hope to see you then. Bye, guys.